Hey everyone, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is André Kröker from Dagobi. Today I would like to show you how to design this badge. Okay, I start this tutorial with the BS logo. I made the BS logo tutorial last week. You can visit my YouTube channel and check out the BS logo tutorial, or you can find the link in the description below. So first I shrink the logo, select the whole group, and now go to the corner points and hold down Alt and Shift. So next, name it to BS. And lock the layer and create a new layer. Go to the layers panel, click on this button, new, create new layer, and move the new layer behind the BS logo. So next, choose the pen tool and create 3 points. So change the color. So I set the stroke color to none. So next, choose the direct selection tool and select the first and the last point. And now go to the top toolbar and choose open this button, align to artboard. Yes, check Align to Artboard and click on this button, Horizontal Align Center. So next, go to the toolbar on the left side and choose the Anchor Point tool and click on the first point. Click and drag your mouse and hold Shift. And click and drag the last point. So next you have to apply an effect. So select the whole shape and now go to Effect, Distort and Transform, and choose Transform. So first enable the preview and Reflect X, and we need one copy. And next click on the center point on the left side and click OK. So choose again the direct selection tool . So and last, select this point and you can see this little dot. Click and drag this point. So next you can select the whole shape and choose the free transform tool and you can scale this. Okay, the next thing what we need to do is expand the transform effect. So select the whole shape and now go to Objects and click Expand Appearance. So now we have two shapes and it's important to unite the shapes. So select both shapes and now open the Pathfinder and click on this button, Unite. So there are one shape So next apply color. So I use gray color for the stroke. So open the stroke panel and change stroke width to 5 points and change line stroke to inside. Click on this button. And I'm going to change the yellow color to gradient. Open the gradient panel and I use this orange yellow gradient. So first change the angle to 45 degree and I'm going to delete one of this anchor points. So delete this point and this point and change the yellow color. Make a double click on the slider and change the color. For example, like that. So that's fine. So next, make a copy of the shape, drag the shape down to the new layers button and take the first shape, open the stroke panel and change align stroke to outside. And I'm going to apply a gold gradient to the stroke. So go to the top toolbar, open the stroke color and click on this button, swatch libraries menu. Go to gradients and choose metals. And I use this dark gold. So, but not for the fill, you have to change to bring the stroke color in foreground and apply this gold. So you can try different angles. So for example 60 degree, so that's fine. So next we need this group and I'm going to make a copy of this group, drag this down to the new layers button and move the new group over the Beers logo. So next, first take this shape and change the color, none color for fill, and change the stroke color to gradient. And I use a black and white gradient. So change the angle to 45 degree, for example. So that one, and change the stroke width to 2 points. So next, I take this gold shape and change the color, stroke color, none. And for the fill, I use black and white gradient. So set this shape to screen. So open the transparency panel and change the blending mode to screen. And I'm going to change the second slider, this black slider, to white. Make a double click on it and change it to white. And set the opacity to 0. And move the gradient slider to left side. So that's fine. And next I'm going to cut the shape. So choose a pen tool and click and drag here and click, for example, here. So next choose the direct selection tool. So So, that's fine. So next, select the path and this shape, shape with the white gradient. And now open the Pathfinder and click on this button, divide. So, but it's very important, before you click on this divide button, it's important to change the color of this new line to none. So first undo divide and now change, select only this new line and change color to none. So now again, select the path and the shape. And now open the Pathfinder and click on the divide button. So now we have two shapes. So, and I'm going to change. So, change the gradient a little bit. So you can change the opacity. So that's fine. Okay, next I'm going to apply a type. So create a new layer and choose the type tool and click on your artboard. So I use 50 points for the font size and I use this type, this font. So make a double click or select all and write basketball. So select the whole group and expand this. So go to type and click create outlines. And now I'm going to change the color. So I use blue color for fill and red color for the stroke. And set the stroke width to 2 points. So you can try to change the line stroke to inside or outside. So I use outside and change the size to 1.5. So next, go to the top toolbar, set align to artboard and click on this button, horizontal align center. So next I'm going to apply two effects. Go to effect, warp and choose arch. So set this to 50%, okay, and now apply a second effect. Go again to effect, warp and this time choose arc. Click on apply new effect and set it to -20% and move type down. So shrink this little bit. And now open the appearance panel and click on the warp arc and change the bend a little bit. So that's fine. Okay. So next I'm going to shrink the whole emblem. So select all and go to this corner and hold down Alt and Shift. So, and move it a little bit down. So next I'm going to apply a crown. So I made this crown logo tutorial in 2017, and you can find the link in this description below. So I copy only the crown logo, copy and paste it in a new layer. So create a new layer and paste. So shrink this crown a little bit. So next I'm going to change the color. So I use dark brown for the stroke and change the stroke white, and I change the line stroke to center. So that's fine. And go to the top toolbar and click on this button, horizontal align center. So basically I'm done, but I'd like to apply some splatter and splashes. So first create a new layer, and now I open the brushes panel, and these are my own brushes. So I use the splatter brushes. So first choose the paintbrush tool and deselect all. First I use blue color for stroke and for example this brush. So next white color and another brush. And red color. And create new layer and move the layer behind all other layers. So with red color and orange color, and last blue color. Okay, I'm done with the emblem and now I'd like to change the color of the beer's logo. So first going to change the white stroke of the beer, change it to red. And change the red stroke color to white. So that's fine. So next I'm going to apply a dark background. So first expand all. So go to select and click select all. So next go to object and click on expand appearance. And next group all. So select again all. Go to object and click group. So this is the whole logo and these layers are empty. So select all and delete these layers. Click on this button, delete selected objects. And now make a copy of the whole group. So, and now select the first group and you have to rasterize it. So go to object and click rasterize. Set this settings, click OK. So this is an image, a pixel image. So next, open this layer and create a big rectangle. Choose a rectangle tool and create a rectangle same size as your artboard. And apply a white and black gradient to the fill color. Change type to radial. And make a double click on the slider and change it to RGB. And on the white slider, the same. And apply a gray color. So like this. And move the black rectangle behind the image. So now change, select the image and change the opacity. Sorry, not the opacity, the blending mode to multiply. So next I'm going to apply a clipping mask. So make a copy of the rectangle and move the copy over the image. Now it's very important, deselect all and click on the group layer and click on this button, make release clipping mask. So next, select the image and you have to apply a blur effect, go to effects and click on Gaussian blur. So I think 10 pixels is okay. So now make the vector group visible and choose the free transform tool and scale the image. So that's fine, or a little bit bigger. So So, if you like, you can change the opacity. So, and last, I'm going to apply shadow. So, select the whole vector group and go to Effect, Stylize, and choose Drop Shadow. Enable the preview. So, I use this settings. That's fine. Click OK. And I like to apply a gradient to the Bears logo. So select the Bears group and go again to Effect, Stylize, and Drop Shadow. And change the Y offset to 2 points or 1.5 and click OK. So last, I'm going to change the blue color of the basketball to white. So, choose a magic wand tool and open the magic wand panel and set the tolerance to 0 and click on the blue color and change the blue color to white. Thanks for watching. If you liked this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, don't forget to subscribe. Hope to see you in the next video.